Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Labs video discussing one of the most common types of temperature sensors, the thermistor. Thermistors are used widely as self-resetting fuses, self-regulating heating elements, and temperature sensors. In this video, we'll get a better understanding of what a thermistor is and compare the primary types of thermistors used for temperature sensing. So, what is a thermistor? Well, short for thermal resistors, a thermistor is a very simple, discrete, two-terminal device whose effective resistance values change with temperature. In this graph, we see a linear thermistor distinguished by its linear characteristic across temperature. Let's take, for example, a thermistor that is in a 25 degrees Celsius environment. Using an ADC, we can measure the voltage drop, V-temp, across a thermistor and find that it is 2.256 volts. From there, you can use any temperature conversion method in software to calculate what temperature the 2.256 volts across the thermistor corresponds to. Once your MCU calculates the temperature, your system can then take the corresponding action depending on the value. Thermistors have existed for over a century, and they have been one of the most used temperature sensing elements in the world, spanning across different markets such as automotive, industrial, personal electronics, and aerospace and defense. Their popularity at the time was largely due to the fact that there weren't many other options such as there are now with temperature sensor ICs. But to this day, they are widely used because of their large selection. You can find thermistors available in a variety of packages, resistance values, and tolerances, which all impact the device cost, providing you both high and low priced options. However, whether you're using a costly or inexpensive thermistor, it's always a good idea to keep in mind that their performance also varies quite a bit. One of the downsides of using thermistors is that the total accuracy of your solution will be highly influenced by the tolerance of not just the thermistor, but also other components within the signal chain, such as the resistors, the ADC, and voltage source, making it more difficult to determine the actual system level accuracy. Although not very accurate in its inception due to an inconsistency in manufacturing and material compositions, thermistor technologies have improved in the most recent decades to improve the consistency and reliability of certain types of thermistors. We can generalize the types of thermistors on the market into two different branches, NTC and PTC. An NTC stands for negative temperature coefficient, meaning that the thermistor decreases its effective resistance as temperature rises. PTC, on the other hand, stands for positive temperature coefficient, and the thermistor increases its effective resistance as temperature rises. From there, each branch can further be generalized into linear and nonlinear characteristics across the operating temperature range. NTCs are only available with a nonlinear change across temperature, whereas PTCs come in both a linear and nonlinear change across temperature. Although there are three main types of thermistors, only the NTC and linear PTCs are used for constant temperature sensing applications. Nonlinear PTC thermistors are typically used for current limiting applications due to their rapid increase of resistance beginning at a specific temperature known as the Curie point. Because of this characteristic, nonlinear PTC thermistors are commonly referred to as switching PTC thermistors. For the rest of this video, we'll be talking about NTCs and linear PTCs as they are the thermistors of choice for temperature sensing applications. The linear PTC thermistor is one of the newer advancements in thermistor technology, bringing along many advantages for applications concerned with reliability, such as lower drift, a smaller thermal mass, and less variation in its manufacturing process. Linear PTCs are made out of silicon and are typically referred to as solistors, meaning silicon thermistors. One downside of linear PTCs, however, is its dynamic range across temperature when compared to NTCs, but this is not an issue in achieving accurate temperature measurements. An NTC thermistor, on the other hand, is the oldest type of thermistor and is made from ceramic metal oxides. Due to this difference in material and its manufacturing process, NTCs are known for having larger tolerances across temperature and greater drift over time. However, they do have a large change in resistance per degree Celsius at cold temperature, and they are also available in a wide variety of probes and package options. One big difference between these two thermistor technologies is their tolerance percentage. In other words, the error between the thermistor's actual and typical effective resistance values provided by the manufacturer. It is important to note that this value in the thermistor datasheets and online catalogs is the rating only at 25 degrees Celsius, not across the whole temperature range. In order to calculate the resistance tolerance across the whole temperature range, you can use the min, typical, and max resistance values provided in your thermistor's resistance to temperature table. For example, let's graph the resistance tolerance across temperature for a 1% linear PTC in black and a 1% NTC in red. You can see that at 25 degrees Celsius, both devices have this 1% tolerance. But as you move away from 25 degrees, the tolerance changes for both technologies. The linear PTC increases an additional 0.5% across the whole temperature range, while the NTC increases its tolerance by an additional 3.25%. It's very important to keep this difference in resistance tolerance across temperature in mind when choosing your thermistor technology. It's always a good idea to calibrate your thermistor, but NTCs are often recommended to have multiple points of calibration done across temperature, because they can vary quite a bit, and this requires a temperature chamber. Linear PTCs, on the other hand, can take advantage of a single point offset correction due to the consistency of silicon and stable error across temperature. There are other differences between linear PTCs and NTCs, such as their drift and response times. Over time, the effective resistance values of a thermistor can drift slightly, which may introduce additional error. As mentioned previously, NTCs drift noticeably more than linear PTCs due to the difference in materials used and added self-heating because of an increase in resistance as temperature rises. These material compositions also affect the thermal mass of both devices, which ends up affecting the response time to temperature changes. Some linear PTCs are able to respond almost 3 times faster than a comparable NTC, which may help your MCU take action when needed the most in critical situations to prevent thermal failures in your system. To summarize, a thermistor changes its effective resistance across temperature. There are two main thermistor technologies that are used for normal temperature sensing, and although there are slight differences in the characteristics and performance between these two types of thermistors, both can be used in the same fashion. Once you start designing, there are many factors that come into play to optimize your thermistor design. In the next video, we'll cover these design considerations and provide some insight into optimizing your thermistor solution. Thank you for watching this introductory video on thermistors used for temperature sensing. For more information, please visit ti.com/thermistors.